Indifference map. Already we have seen how an indifference curve for a hypothetical consumer shall be obtained. This doesn't mean an individual has only one indifference curve. He has a number of indifference curves. A collection of indifference curves is called indifference map. An indifference map reflects the behavior of an individual consumer. In this lesson, we shall see some of the finer details of indifference map. The two assumptions that help us to understand the indifference map are: 1. Preference indifference hypothesis. 2. Consumer has the ability to rank his preferences. On the face of it, the two assumptions may look difficult to understand. In reality, it is not so. In the course of my explanation, you will easily understand this. Let us make use of our familiar example: consumer consuming combinations of good X and good Y. Look at this graph sheet. Good Y is represented along the Y axis and good X along the X axis. In this space, there are uncountable number of combinations. Let us represent a few points. Each point represents a combination of two goods. Among these combinations, the consumer is able to assign equal ranks to a few. They are shown as yellow colored dots. Let us allow a curve through these points. We shall name it as IC1. All the combinations on this IC curve are equally acceptable to the consumer. It means consumer is indifferent among these combinations. This is what we mean by indifference hypothesis. Again, the consumer is able to identify another set of combinations. They are shown by green colored dots. Let us draw a smooth curve joining all these points. This is another indifference curve. We shall name it as IC2. It represents a higher level of satisfaction than IC1. Quantitatively, we cannot say how much more. Just a higher level, that's all. The speciality is all of them yield the same level of satisfaction. Consumer is again indifferent among these combinations. This is the right time to understand the preference hypothesis. Look at the ICs. IC1 represents a lower level of satisfaction. IC2 represents a higher level of satisfaction. But why? We have to find an answer to this question. The second assumption comes to our rescue. Consumer has the ability to rank his preferences. For this, let us take two combinations, F and G. Combination F is on IC1, combination G is on IC2. Combination F and G contains same quantity of good Y, 8 units. But combination F contains only 1 unit of good X. And the combination G contains 2 units of good X. Since G comprises of more units of good X, it yields a higher level of satisfaction. So our consumer prefers G over F. This is his preference. He is not indifferent between these two. When F and G are offered to him, he categorically prefers G. This is known as preference hypothesis. Look at the consumer. Within the indifference curve, the consumer is indifferent. But between the indifference curves, the consumer is able to show his preference. Look where the consumer now is. Consumer being indifferent among the combinations on the same indifference curve, and at the same time capable of expressing his preference one over the other when the two combinations are on the two different indifference curves, is what is known as preference-indifference hypothesis. Consumer, by identifying one group of combinations, obtain IC1. And now, from his second group, he gets IC2. Similarly, the consumer can draw his other indifference curves. What is true of IC1 and IC2 is true for every other ICs so obtained. In fact, the consumer can get as many ICs in this space as these four indifference curves are just sufficient for our analysis. Let us do away with the points. What are we supposed to keep in our mind about the indifference map? It shows the taste and preference of the consumer. He behaves according to this map. He wants to reach the highest possible indifference curve. An indifference curve that lies to the left of a given indifference curve represents a lower level of satisfaction. IC1 gives less satisfaction than IC2. An IC that lies to the right of a given indifference curve represents higher level of satisfaction. IC3 gives more satisfaction than IC2. And don't forget, slope of the indifference curve shows the rate at which the consumer would like to exchange one good for another. This is very, very important for analyzing consumer equilibrium. Very shortly, we are going to discuss that consumer equilibrium. Thanks for watching. Meet you all again.